Namaste and welcome to today's episode. We all have heard this saying, as cool as a cucumber. Yes, today we are going to talk about cucumber. Cucumber is another life-changing, life-healing food that we all should be eating on a daily basis. Now, during lockdown, what I'm seeing is, and when we review a lot of reports of clients and people, we are seeing dehydration is going up. Dehydration because you are sitting at home, you are, by virtue of not stepping out, exertion levels are low and you're not drinking enough water. As a result, subclinical dehydration is on a rise during this time. Now, we all know dehydration has negative effect on the body. We do not want our cell to be deprived of enough nutrient-rich, electrolyte-rich water. Now, if you have a history or if you have a tendency of being dehydrated frequently, your best antidote is to have cucumber. Now, cucumber hydrates you at the deepest cellular level. And we all know each and every impact in the body happens when it happens at a cellular level. Whether it is nutrition, whether it is absorption, digestion, elimination, energy generation, anything. Anything will happen only at a cellular level. And for that to happen, you need to have a sufficient balance of electrolytes, trace minerals, magnesium, potassium, sodium in the body. And all this can be done if you just eat plain, rich cucumber. Now, it is excellent to rejuvenate your heart, the liver. It is very good for liver which are hot, liver which are stagnant, liver which are sluggish. People who have any liver-related ailment should be looking to add cucumbers in the diet. Now, daily eating one cucumber, okay, daily, can reverse most of your liver-related issues. Be it fatty liver, be it sluggish liver, be it liver scarring, be it liver being hot, liver not able to carry on the work that it's supposed to be done. Now, if you have bloating in your liver or if you have bloating in your body, okay, cucumber comes to rescue because it has got a diuretic impact, and most importantly, it cools down the body. So if you have an acidic body, cucumber eating increases the alkalinity of your body and make it more prone or more open to absorb nutrient than when a body is in an acidic state. Now, it is also very good if you have a adrenal gland fatigue, means if you have been under any kind of stress for a very, very long time. Okay, can be physical stress, mental stress, emotional stress, psychological stress, any stress, oxidative stress or metabolic stress caused by your lifestyle. Maybe you're working out too much and then that is also creating a lot of oxidative stress. Now, when that stress is high, your adrenal glands produces more hormones to bring that stress down. Okay, to move you from that sympathetic nervous system to a parasympathetic nervous system. Now, to move from one state to another, one of the best aid can be to have cucumber, because cucumber helps to support your adrenal gland, which over a period of time, by constantly moving from a sympathetic to a parasympathetic mode, they become fatigued and then they're not able to manage that stress that you're doing. And then there are times when you get up, you don't have enough energy, or if you check your morning cortisol levels, you will see your cortisol level will be on the lower side on the scale, within the range but on the lower side. You would want your morning cortisol to be in the range but on the upper side of your reference range. So if that is the case, that means your adrenal glands have been fatigued. Trust me, a majority of people have sub-fatigue adrenal glands. So it will be a good idea to add cucumber in your diet. Now, there are a lot of people who have tendency of having high uric acid. Okay, we all know uric acid is an antioxidant. The problem is when the uric acid does not come out of your body and start getting deposited in your body, because your kidneys are not able to filter the frequency and the amount of uric acid your body is generating versus the capacity of kidneys to filter them out. Now, when uric acid remains in the system for a long, it causes load and it heats up your kidney, okay, thus impacting the filtration capacity of a kidney. And we know kidneys are very, very delicate organs. So what we have to do is, we should eat more cucumber, because cucumber helps to reduce the heat caused by high uric acid in our body, especially in the kidneys. Okay, so it increases the EGFR, the filtration capacities of your kidneys, if you are eating one cucumber on a daily basis. Now, traditionally, okay, if you see, when kids or anybody in the family used to have fever, they were given cucumber to eat to bring the fever down. Cucumber has been applied on face, on topically on your skin, has been used as a cooling agent, as an eye patch, face mask to get your skin rehydrated, and if it is consumed internally, it cleans and calms and detoxify all your organs as well. Now, people who have issues of anxiety, okay, people who have neurological issues, people who get palpitation because of anxiety, they're unable to think, they have this racing mind, racing heart, okay, they should definitely add cucumber in their diet, preferably in the daytime, not post sunset, but during the daytime, morning and afternoon is the best time to eat. Now, what makes them a very good food for managing anxiety is because they are rich in, so while cucumber has a lot more than 50 trace minerals, two amazing amino acids that cucumber has is glycine and glutamine. Now, glutamine is the same amino acid which is used to heal your gut lining. In the gut, there are something known as brush border enzymes. Okay, these are like receptors, like dendrites, like threads, which absorb, which attach to food, absorb, and then pass on what is good into the blood, and hold what is bad into the system. Now, when your gut becomes leaky, this gets damaged, or you're eating a lot of acidic food, this gets damaged. Hence, your ability to absorb better food and nutrient becomes low. So, glutamine helps to repair that, and cucumber is rich in that. So, if you just eat cucumber, you are supporting your gut lining to regenerate and to rejuvenate itself. Now, if you have access to organic desi cucumber, okay, so you get desi cucumber, you get hybrid cucumber, you get English, you get Chinese. There are multiple varieties of cucumber. So, if you get a hands-on desi organic cucumber, try and eat them with skin. Now, the skin of cucumber is rich in chlorophyll, and the chlorophyll of the skin attaches with B vitamin, vitamin A, and vitamin C, which is in abundance in cucumber, and ensure that it gets absorbed into your intestine, into your liver, and it has a cellular impact. In case you cannot get an organic source, then it will be a good idea to peel it and consume it. Now, cucumbers are very good for digestion also, and that's the reason they are one of the top choices when it comes to adding it into a part of a salad. Okay, because salad helps to increase the stomach acid, it helps to digest the food, and that's why they are added pre to a meal, especially when you are eating a high protein dense meal. Now, if you have any of the medical conditions or symptoms, I think you should be adding cucumber in your diet. Things like any kidney related issue. Okay, whether you have a missing kidney, whether the kidney is not functioning, if you are on dialysis, you should be looking at adding cucumber to your diet, but definitely you want to speak to your doctor, and you do not want to add too much of it at one go. Okay, if you have adrenal fatigue, if you have issues with anxiety, if you are diabetic, if you have a tendency of gaining weight, if you have any of a skin condition like eczema, psoriasis, conditions related to infertility, chronic fatigue syndrome, multiple sclerosis, lupus, if you have recurring yeast infection, okay, and if you have sunburn, if your skin gets burned whenever you step out, I think cucumber is something that can come to your rescue. If you are facing issues with respect to dandruff, if you are facing issues with respect to bloating, if you are facing issues related to gastric spasm, stagnant liver, if you have an itchy skin, so the skin is itchy all the time and you just keep on applying coconut oil and other things topically and you're still not getting relief, there is certain allergy in your body. You would want to make your body from an acidic to an alkaline state by adding cucumber in your diet. If females are facing issues of hot flashes, if you are into a menopause stage, or if you have a chronic PMS, post-menstrual syndrome, the chronic pain that starts 7 to 6 days before your monthly cycle, you definitely want to add cucumber to your regular diet. And if your body is acidic, definitely cucumber will come to your rescue. A good benchmark, start slowly with half a cucumber, move up to 2 cucumbers daily during the daytime, and you will see the life-changing effect or impact that this simple fruit makes in a life. Have a wonderful day, everyone, and we'll catch up soon. Namaste.